Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, podcast episode 2327. Pick from drop-down list, not using data validation. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a great tip sent in by Rico S. Talking about using the program key plus K to pick from the drop-down list. And I'm not talking about a drop-down list that's created by data validation. Those are a pain, and if you have 1,000 of them, it's going to take a lot of overhead. And I'm not talking about autocomplete, although I think what we're talking about is related to autocomplete. So I have a nice little column there, apple, banana, cherry. I just type A, it says apple, I press enter and move on with my life. B, enter, cherry, C for cherry, move on with my life. And that works great until we come up with something ambiguous like applesauce, right? Now, well, B still works, but if I type A, it doesn't know what to do, right? I have to keep typing until I get out to something that's not ambiguous and then press enter. So, Rico says, here's what we're going to do. We're going to use the program key. If you don't have this, it's Shift F10. Program key, press and release the program key, and then press and release K. What's that doing? Well, if I press and release the program key, you see that the K is called pick from drop-down list. I don't know how long this has been there. Is this new? Is this old? Maybe it's been there for 20 years and I've never noticed it. But check out what it does. So, I come here, program key K, and it gives me a list that I can arrow through to choose, right? And what's weird, tab doesn't work, but if I press enter, it chooses applesauce, but leaves me in that cell. So it almost comes down to, I'm going to have to press program key, K, down, 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 enter, enter, to move to the next one. Program key, K, down, 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 enter, enter, to move to the next cell. It's pretty cool that there's a drop-down list there that just gets created on the fly. You don't need to set up data validation. But, you know, my first reaction is this somewhere in the ribbon? Because what I want to do, I want to right-click and then right-click, say, pick from drop-down list, add to quick access toolbar. That way, I could maybe get an easier keyboard shortcut than this admittedly weird program key K. Yeah, I'm just not a fan of that. I'd love to have it be the second item in the quick access toolbar. But when we go to customize quick access toolbar and all commands, pick from drop-down list is not there, and I've looked for everything else. Select from drop-down list, choose from drop-down list, and it just does not appear to be anywhere. How can it be that this got in the product only as a right-click key and not as an actual command up in the ribbon? Isn't that weird? And here, let's check it out. Test some limits here. So I have about 193 phrases. I think I started in row 3 on this. Yeah, so 194 phrases, a lot of different phrases, program key K, and it offers an alphabetical list of everything above me, even all the way down to, yeah, so 100, you know, it works with 190 items. It's a cool feature, kind of hidden, especially hidden for me because I never think to right click. And I just kind of wonder, you know, where it came from. So, hey, I want to hear from you. If you've used this, if you have any tips for this, if you can figure out any way to assign a better shortcut key to it other than, you know, a send keys macro, that's going to be so unreliable. But maybe it's better. I don't know. Let me know. Leave a note down in the YouTube comments. Thanks very much. Hey, and I appreciate all the people that have subscribed recently, trying to get to that 100,000 level. If you like this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. The new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly, click the I in the top right-hand corner. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.